Yeah, don't worry about bringing the trucks back over. We're shutting down. Loaded. Let's go put it on. Play arms taking the service truck. We might need that too. Dumping, conveyor's working, swing out auger on the hoppers, working good, tracker's fueled. We need to get a truck back to the field, so I gotta get this thing done fast so I can get on the road, get back, because those combines are gonna be sitting. Grain cart, anybody? Would that help situation? I think it would. It's a little bit of a bottleneck with that auger being down, but we got two drivers now in the trucks, and we got another truck that's not in the field yet. I'm on my way right now. I gotta get there quick because combines are waiting. So I'm gonna hightail it over there about 8 miles and get back there, fill the truck up, get them cutting again. We'll get another truck back to the field and it's just gonna get crazy. All right, keep rolling. There's a lot of vehicles we got to shuttle. The Brute, which is our fire truck, the Fummins, 3 grain trucks, and 2 combines. Finish this field. There's a little bit of green spots in that we left. We're going to come back and hit on the way out, but we got the 2 hills. I don't know what we call these, the roller coaster road, but they're kind of these nasty ditches you got to drive up and down. And, well, the combines, it was a little sketchy with those headers, but we got it. So it's going to be fun. This is always the enjoyable place to haul out of. And if you're going to break down on the farm, it always happens at this field. Yeah, don't worry about bringing the trucks back over. We're shutting down. So the rain's finally come. It's coming down. Not heavy, but enough to stop us. And there's more coming tonight. So probably done for the weekend.
We got Clifford right here. My dad's gone by. He's unloading what he's got. And then I'll probably run this thing back. Park at the farmyard. And the guys will take the pickup back. And we'll leave the combine here over the weekend. That's what happens when you drive back on the dusty roads after a little bit of rain. Fortunately, the 9370 with the Demco trailer, Brad's gonna go wash it off, so he'll keep that nice and clean. We might give these a wash too. But we're just getting the last of the trucks emptied out. This one doesn't have a tarp, so we're getting everything out into the bin. And the rain is gonna start in about, I should say, more rain is gonna start in about an hour. And then we're supposed to get 3/10 tonight, 2/10 tomorrow, and 3/10 Sunday. So we could have as much as almost 3/4 inch or around a 1/2 inch rain. Either way, we're done for a few days. It's not what we'd like. We'd like to keep going. But you know what? That's the life of farming. Well, we're back at the farmyard, doing some odds and ends, some things like getting the sprayers ready to go. Hopefully tomorrow we can spray. It's lightly raining on us right now. Not gonna be harvested anytime soon. I'm working on a toilet. That's pretty cool. Calcium buildup over the years. Wouldn't flush. Little muriatic acid's taking care of that business. It's gonna flush like a dream when I'm done with it. We'll see what happens with this weather coming in. It hit over where we were a minute ago, but I don't know. It's gonna keep wetting stuff down and it's gonna delay harvest a little bit. We'll get it done. Hey, so things keep changing. Well, what's on the agenda today? Basically, this morning we woke up, there was a really, really, really thick fog. Thickest fog we've seen since spring. It's just clearing out. The sun is finally poking its pretty face at us. And because of all the moisture we got, we even had some more rain last night. We're not gonna be cutting anytime soon. But we're gonna go ahead and shovel some grain around. We got some grain bins. I need the grain inside moved to other bins so we can free up space. So, let's go. I got the 4520. I'm taking it over to the bin site. And we're gonna get set up. We're gonna pull the seed out of that bin. It's spring wheat seed, and we're gonna get it ready to put this year's crop in it. Let's roll.
One thing pretty sweet about this 4520, it is a power shift. Check it out.
Thank you.
that time. Gotta go knock out some acres. We got 3,000 to do. We're not gonna get it all done today. We're gonna get a chunk of it done and then get back in the combine maybe tomorrow. But I got this to do. So yeah, big brute time.
In the past, I've talked about chem follow. Chemical follow is like summer follow. It's a technique that's used up here to conserve water on land and hopefully get the next year's crop to be better. This is what happens when chem follow starts to grow and you haven't gotten to anything. This is kochia, fireweed, and it's probably beyond the stage of being able to really kill it effectively. We're gonna spray it, probably not gonna fully die. This is the problem with running chem follow up here in this country. If this were crop, even though it might be less yield, you wouldn't have this pressure of weeds in it. It's a tricky thing, because right now we are in the heat of harvest. We don't want to be messing with that right now. Though I do like them. But I don't want to be messing with that right now. I don't want to be spraying fields, throwing money at this to kill this. I want to be in the field harvesting a crop where I can hopefully make money. It's a tricky situation. But you know what? You deal with what hand you're given. And right now, this is on the pressing moment. We have a wet ground. I can't harvest right now because, well, I should say the crop's wet. But I can drive on it with the sprayer, so why not throw some spray at this stuff, hopefully kill it, because if you don't, this is all going to go to the seed, and it's going to be a wreck. So, back to sprayer.
Well, that wasn't a full day, but I got 600 acres done with this sprayer alone. The other sprayer's probably done at least 500 acres, so that's a chunk done for the day. We'll see if we can get done tomorrow, then back to harvesting, because, well, I think we'll try tomorrow, but we might be able to start cutting soon.
Well, guys, like always, appreciate you watching the videos. Helps me out, makes it motivated to make more. And you know what? It's a lot happening on our farm because of you guys. Check the result. And Brad, he's employed because of us, because of you guys. Anyways, that sure is gonna look nice every walk of this. So thanks guys, take care, God bless. Subscribe to the channel. Check us out on Instagram, Facebook, Twitter, all that good stuff. Got merchandise, it's all there. So I'm gonna go get a shower. See ya.